be it your DNA, chlorophyll for plants, or proteins for microorganisms, nitrogen is ruling like a boss. Not just restricted to contribute the major 78.09% of the atmosphere. Rather, nitrogen is one of the essentials for terrestrial ecosystem. Apart from oxygen, hydrogen, and carbon, nitrogen is another critical subject legit for the survival of living organisms. Recognizing this importance in the vitality of nitrogen in the terrestrial ecosystem, this is Earthy Perks, dedicating the episode to appreciate nitrogen for being such an imperative support. When it is about terrestrial environment, here we go with five important phenomena that helps to make the most out of the 78.09% of environmental nitrogen. Collectively, they are termed as nitrogen cycle. Nitrogen is one of the primary nutrients critical for the survival of all living organisms. As dinitrogen gas, N2, it is largely inaccessible in this form to most organisms, making nitrogen a scarce resource and often limiting primary productivity in many ecosystems. Only when nitrogen is converted from dinitrogen gas into ammonia, NH3, does it become available to primary producers, such as plants. The major transformations of nitrogen are nitrogen fixation, nitrification, denitrification, anammox, and ammonification. The transformation of nitrogen into its many oxidation states is key to productivity in the biosphere, and it is highly dependent on the activities of a diverse assemblage of microorganisms, such as bacteria, archaea, and fungi. Starting with nitrogen fixation, the process of converting N2 into biologically available nitrogen is called nitrogen fixation. N2 gas is a very stable compound due to the strength of the triple bond between the nitrogen atoms, and it requires a large amount of energy to break this bond. The whole process requires 8 electrons and at least 16 ATP molecules. Next comes the nitrification. Nitrification is the process that converts ammonia to nitrite and then to nitrate, and is another important step in the global nitrogen cycle. There are two distinct steps of nitrification that are carried out by distinct types of microorganisms. The first step is the oxidation of ammonia to nitrite, which is carried out by microbes known as ammonia oxidizers. The second step in nitrification is the oxidation of nitrite, NO2 negative, to nitrate, NO3 negative. Third process on the go is anammox. Anammox, anaerobic ammonia oxidation, is carried out by prokaryotes belonging to the planktomycetes phylum of bacteria. The first described anammox bacterium was Brocadia anammoxidans. Anammox bacteria oxidize ammonia by using nitrite as the electron acceptor to produce gaseous nitrogen. The anammox process is considered to be responsible for a significant loss of nitrogen. Fourth on the list is denitrification. It is the process that converts nitrate to nitrogen gas, thus removing bioavailable nitrogen and returning it to the atmosphere. Dinitrogen gas, N2, is the ultimate end product of denitrification, but other intermediate gaseous forms of nitrogen exist. Some of these gases, such as nitrous oxide, N2O, are considered greenhouse gases, reacting with ozone and contributing to air pollution. Denitrification is an anaerobic process, occurring mostly in soils and sediments and anoxic zones in lakes and oceans. Some denitrifying bacteria include species in the genera Bacillus, Pericoccus, and Pseudomonas. Denitrification is important in that it removes fixed oxygen, i.e. nitrate, from the ecosystem and returns it to the atmosphere in a biologically inert form, N2. Last but not least is the fifth process, the ammonification. When an organism excretes waste or dies, the nitrogen in its tissues is in the form of organic nitrogen, e.g. amino acids, DNA. Various fungi and prokaryotes then decompose the tissue and release inorganic nitrogen back into the ecosystem as ammonia in the process known as ammonification. The ammonia then becomes available for uptake by plants and other microorganisms for growth. This is how nitrogen is playing an irreplaceable role in maintaining the terrestrial ecosystem. With all this, Earthy Perks here signs off to let you consider the importance of nitrogen. Till next time, stay stay tuned.